In this section, we're going to be talking about computers, and I brought in an expert because we rely heavily on subject matter experts for computers, for networks, for hard drives, to give us the best advice and the most advanced advice up to date. So today I'm joined with Justin from Jolt here in St. Louis. Justin has set us up with our internal hardware system for our routers, for our network, and has built our Synology and our backup system. So in this section, I wanted to bring in an expert that knows way more than we do on the topic of computers. And our hope today is to give you more knowledge about computers so you can make a better educated decision. Now, the one drawback with anything about computers is it's going to be out of date probably tomorrow. So we want to give you guys a framework and a little bit more of a knowledge base to make a better educated decision on PCs or Macs. So which is better, Macs or PCs?
It's totally a personal preference. It's what do you feel comfortable with, and at the end of the day, do you want to have it totally customized to how you want it, or do you want it where you get in the chute, you plug in your computer, and you're ready to go?
Let's start with the operating systems. What's the difference between a PC operating system, which is made by Windows, or a Mac-based system, which is made by Apple?
Yeah, so basically it comes down to their core foundation. Mac is based off a Unix system. That's an open source style platform that basically it's built on. One kind of key thing about Apple is they basically put the work in front of you and they hide all the settings and the options. So basically the idea is you get in, you get working. If you need to get to settings, you can dig a little deeper, but it's not going to be right there glaring in your face. Windows is a more DOS-based operating system. That's what it's based off of. And it is a lot more customizable. There's a lot more options you can do with it, but it also does require a lot more tinkering and kind of some more knowledge in that area than a Mac is.
What are some of the things that are an example of an additional way to customize a PC versus a Mac?
Sure, especially in like the desktop area of it, that's where you can really get in and you can change out hard drives, you can change out memory, power supplies, motherboards, processors. You can get in there and change the power of your computer. So in 2 years, when it starts to get a little outdated, you can replace that part with a new piece. Where on Mac on that, virtually all their machines are part changeable. So basically what you buy day one is the same computer you're gonna have in 4 years.
So we have a PC and a Mac. We tried to bring two of computers that were comparable together. Mm-hmm. In your opinion, for giving advice to someone who's gonna be shooting Tethered, what are the benefits of a PC versus a Mac? Are there one or the other?
It just depends on your skill level, your knowledge, and kind of your background. If you are a person who basically, you want to walk in the studio, you want to open up your computer, plug in a camera, you have a client coming in a half hour, and you just want to shoot, I would say definitely look towards the Mac route. That's kind of their target audience. If you're a PC person, you like PCs, you've worked with them your whole life, it's definitely still a good option, but just keep in mind you have to watch out for things like updates, compatibility, and just kind of all those different factors.
So if you're using something like Lightroom or Capture One or other capture software, it's a good idea to maybe have a dedicated system specifically for shooting Tethered, and you have a system like a laptop or a desktop that's your personal computer, and to treat your shooting Tethered station as something that you update 2, 3, 4 months if a new operating system comes out or new updates come out, when you can read and research online whether or not those updates are affecting or working well with Capture One. It's one of those things that you don't want to be the newest person to have the newest updates all the time, because if you're on set and you have clients and you haven't tested this for many, many, many shoots, then it's something that you're running a risk of running into problems on set because you've upgraded too early and you now have a problem. So keep that in mind as you are shooting and as you are, you know, keeping up to date. You can be too up to date,
yes,
and that can be a problem.
Yes.
Do PCs and Macs auto-update?
They have definitely an option to do that. That's the default on a lot of these are. So that's what you'll see pop-ups pop up saying update's available. And if you don't look hard and you just click update now, it's going to go. And sometimes some of these updates can take 10 to 15 minutes, which can be very awkward in the middle of a shoot to just have your computer
Absolutely.
Start updating.
So let's talk a little bit about, we've covered software. Let's talk a little bit about the hardware differences between a Mac and a PC.
Mm-hmm.
What are the differences?
There really isn't many. At the end of the day, most of these have Intel chips inside them, which they're the same parts used on either side. The one thing to kind of note is there are low-end PCs, and there really isn't a low-end Mac. That's the difference you'll see there. You can buy a $300 PC, but you can't buy a Mac that way. Apple basically cuts out the low-end, and they start at medium tier and then high-end tier.
So what would you consider to be medium tier processors by today's standard?
That would probably be the i5s from Intel. Intel's kind of the industry standard right now in processors. There are AMDs as well, but Intel's kind of the main one to stick with. And that would probably be your mid tier base level i5s. You can't have higher level i5s and i7, and that would be your high tier.
So i5s and i7s aren't something that's new. That's been around for many years. Are those all the same? Or are they different generations?
No, there's definitely different generations. We are on the sixth generation right now, and you'll hear names like Skylake and so on, and that's the different names for those processors. Different speeds definitely involved. So those are the things you have to keep in mind when you get a computer. If you have a generation 4 i5 versus a generation 6, there are drastic differences.
So what would you say the biggest differences are from generation to generation? How much am I missing out on by getting a new one as
Sure.
opposed to a cheaper one that's a little bit older?
The main question then becomes, how long do you want this computer for? Are you expecting to use this computer for 3 years? Are you really want to try to eke out 4 years out of it? And kind of what's your desire with that? Because sometimes you can go with a level down processor with the understanding of, hey, in 2 years, this is probably going to be an underpowered machine that I need to upgrade. Or I want to buy in on a really nice computer that I can have for 3 or 4 years.
So processors by Intel, it's pretty much just Intel processors in PCs and Macs.
That's correct. You can have the exact same processor in this computer as well as in this machine.
Well, let's talk a little bit about RAM and graphics cards. Are those the same as well?
There is definitely some overlapping there. Almost all of them use the exact same parts. So some will use NVIDIA or Intel integrated graphics. And memory, you can literally go buy the exact same stick off the shelf as long as they're compatible and put it in a Mac or a PC.
So earlier you mentioned that PCs were quite a bit more customizable for hardware than Macs were. But one thing I've noticed with the laptops on how thin both of them are getting is that almost neither of these are now customizable. Why is that?
That's correct. Basically now it's a competition who can build the thinnest, lightest computer. And when that happens, it's just they don't have room to make the screws and to make it user replaceable. It's something where in laptop realm, it's almost becoming impossible to replace parts. It's only in the desktops in the PC world that you're seeing replaceable parts.
So they're actually with the solid state hard drives, which are much smaller than the traditional hard disk drives. They're actually being soldered, just like the RAM, onto the board itself.
That's correct.
And that's because it makes it faster and it makes it smaller and lighter.
Exactly.
Another thing that I want to talk about is the ports on the computers. Now, with every new computer comes with a new port. Apple just came out with USB-C, correct?
That's correct.
So what is that and why do I need it?
Sure. USB-C is just a style of connector of USB 3. USB 3 is kind of the fastest version of USB that's out right now. The one thing to keep in mind with USB is that it's a variable speed based on the processor in your computer. Another basically popular port that's out right now is Thunderbolt. There's three versions of the Thunderbolt now. We're on Thunderbolt 3 right now, you're seeing. And the difference with it is there's actually a chip in it that makes that speed so it's constant, where USB is more of a variable-based speed.
And Thunderbolt 3 is now starting to be found on PCs, correct?
That's like correct. Based on high-end level PCs, you're starting to see Thunderbolt as an option. Intel is basically the creator of Thunderbolt.
So today, it's all about the price and what you're comfortable with. If we would recommend that you go out, if you don't have a shoot station yet and you want to maybe get a laptop, go out, get a PC and a Mac from somewhere that has a good return policy. Install a trial version of whatever Capture One or Lightroom, and use them for a few weeks. Put them through the paces. Get one from Apple with 16 gigabytes of RAM, and get one on a PC that has maybe 32 gigabytes of RAM. See what really works for you, and use that as your benchmark to see what is working. So with that, I think that is a good overview of what to kind of consider when looking at a PC versus a Mac. Again, we don't think that there's one better than the other. It comes down to personal preference, it comes down to cost, and it comes down to what you're comfortable with. So in the next sections, we want to get into the differences between things like your cores, what RAM is, hard disk drives versus solid state drives. We want to kind of analyze the hardware of the system and really what that is.